Everyone, welcome back to new video. In this video, we're going to create a complete to-do application with the help of MVI Architecture. So in this project, we will learn what is MVI Architecture and how to use MVI Architecture. So without wasting any time, let's get started. MVI is an acronym of three different words: Model, View, Intent. So the responsibility of model is to fetch data either from remote or local data source. Apart from this, it also contains all of your business logic. Next, we are having intent. So intent contains all of our intents that you want in your project. Next, we are having view. So the responsibility of a view is to show the view. Basically, it contains your composable screens or XML. So let's begin with our to-do application. So in to-do application, we are having here first the packages. So first package name would be model. Next, we are having intent. Lastly, we are having view. And in this view, I'm gonna put my UI and my main activity. So let's begin with our model. So model contain all of the logic that is related to the getting data from remote or local data source. In this project, we're gonna use a room database because we want to save the to-do items into my database. So let's begin with our model. So in model, I'm gonna create one more package. The package name would be a local, and in this local, we are having our database. And the database name would be to-do database. It's a class, not a normal class, it's an abstract class. And this will extend my room database. On the top, I'm gonna use here database annotation, and this database annotation requirement is entities that you want to save into your database. Next, we are having database version. So for the time being, I'm gonna pass one. I'm gonna use here companion object, and in this companion object, I'm gonna create a function naming get instance pass context, and this will return me to-do database. For that, first you have to create your to-do database with the help of room. So room database builder, pass your context. Next, you have to pass the database name, which is to-do database class.java. Lastly, you have to pass the name of this database. So I'm using here to-do, and next I'm gonna build it. So this will give me to-do database. Now it's time to create our entity. So in the local, I'm gonna create a data class, and this data class name would be to-do. In this, we are having three things. First, we are having title. Next, we are having ID. And this ID will represent our primary key. And lastly, we are having is done or not. So basically, it represents a boolean. Initial value would be false. And in order to create a primary key, we should use your primary key annotation on the top of our ID. And by default, I'm going to initialize this thing with 0. And I want to insert this thing in a form of entity to my database. So for that, we have to use your entity. And in this, we have to pass the table name. So I'm going to pass here to-do table. So that's all for our entity. Now go back to your to-do database, and here in the entities, I'm gonna register my to-do class. So we are pretty much done with our database and its entities. Now it's time to create our data access object, which actually used to access my database operation. So this is an interface, and interface name would be to-do data access object. In order to make this interface a data access object, you should use annotation DAO on the top of this interface. And in this, we are having functions. So first, I'm going to use here insert and insert my to-do. Next, we are having update. Pass your to-do. Next, we are having delete. Simply pass your to-do that you want to delete. And lastly, we are having one function which actually get all the to-do list from our room database. So this time, I'm going to use here normal function get to-do list, and this will return a flow. This flow contain my list of to-do in it. That's it. Now, in order to perform insertion in our database, we have annotation here, insert. And in this, we are having on conflict strategy. So basically, if the same ID is already put into your database and you want to insert a new item with the same ID, on that scenario, it will replace the older one. Next, we are having update, so use update. Lastly, we are having delete, so simply use delete. Okay, so in order to get all the list from the database, what you can do, you can write a query. So in this query, I'm gonna use select all column from my to-do table. So this will give you all the items which is present into my to-do database. All right, so we are pretty much done with data access object. Now it's time to use dependency inject. For that, I'm gonna create a package, and the package name is DI. And in this DI, I'm gonna create an object, and the object name is model module. This is an object, and on the top, I'm gonna use here install in singleton component class. This is a module, so use here module annotation. And in this first, I'm gonna provide my database. So this is a singleton, and I want to provide this thing. So that's why I'm using provide annotation. Now it's time to create a function. So provide database, and the requirement of database is application context. So simply pass your context, and this will give you to-do database. I'm using here return to-do database contain get instance function. This is a companion object function. and in this you can pass your context. Next we have to provide our data access object. So for that I'm using here provides function provide data access object, and this data access object requirement is to do database. This will give you to do data access object, but in order to write this interface implementation we will use room. So how our room library will write implementation for to do data access object? So in order to write implementation, go to your to do database, and here just below to your companion object you're gonna create a abstract function naming it to do DAO, and return type is to do DAO. So this will eventually implement all of your functions which is printed into your to do data access object. Now go to your model module, and I'm gonna use to do database get to do DAO, and this will return me my data access object implementation. So we are done with our database setup. Now it's time to create a repository. So in the model I'm having a package, and the package name would be repository. So in this repository I'm having an interface, and the interface name would be to do repository. In this interface we are having four functions. First we are having here insert. In this we have to pass our to do. Next we are having delete, again pass to do. Next we have a function for update, pass your to do. And lastly we are having a function which get all the to do items, so get all to do list, and this will return me flow of list of to do. This is my interface. Now it's time to implement this repository interface. So in the repository I'm gonna create a class, and the class name would be to do repo impl. This will implement my to do repository. So in this we are having four different functions, and this four different function requirement is data access object, because we want to perform operation into our database. So private wall to do data access object. Now in insert I'm gonna use my to do data access object and perform the insert, pass your to do. Similarly for the delete I'm gonna use my to do data access object, perform delete, pass your to do. You can use to do data access object dot update and pass your to do. Lastly we are having get all to do's list. So in this case I'm gonna use here equals to do data access object dot get to do list. So this is our implementation. Now it's time to provide this implementation with the help of Dagger Hilt. So go to your model module, provide function. So this will provide me my repository. So provide a repository, and the requirement of repository implementation is to do data access object. So pass it, and return type would be to do repository. All right, so we are done with our implementation part. Now it's time to begin with our intents. So intents contain all of our intents that we want into my project. Like in my project, we are having three main intents. We want to insert something, we want to delete something, and update something. So for that we are having here a class, and this class name would be to do intent. This is not a normal class, it's a sealed class, and in this we have to add all of our intents. So first intent would be insert, and in this insert we have to pass our to do that we want to insert into my database, and this will eventually extend my to do intent. Similarly we are having two more things. We are having here update. Lastly we are having a delete. As I told you, we have only three intents. So now we are done with our intents. It's time to begin with our view. So in the view, we are having main activity. And in this main activity, we're gonna write our main screen. So first, let's remove this thing. Remove this greeting. And on the top, I'm using here Android entry point, because we want to do some field injection in here. So that field injection would be our repository. So before writing our user interface, I think we should set up our Dagger Hilt. So for that, go to MVI to do app package, right click, new, create a class, and the class name would be base application. This is a class, and this class extend application, and the top you should use Hilt Android app. Now it's time to register this base application. Go to manifest, in the Android manifest, username, and register your application. So now I'm gonna create my composable screen. So composable naming is main screen, and in this we have two different input parameters. So the first parameter is our list of to-dos. Next I'm having here a lambda, and this lambda is used to transfer our intent to my parent composable, and naming would be on intent, and in this the input parameter is to do intent, and the output is unit. This I'm gonna use here scaffold, and this scaffold contain a top app bar. This top app bar title would be to do items. This is an experimental API, so simply add experimental material theory API on the top of our composable. Now in this scaffold I'm gonna check if my list is empty On that case, I'm using here a box having modifier, padding, fill max size, and the content alignment on the center. And it simply says to me nothing found. Else we're gonna create a lazy column. This lazy column have modifier. Padding is coming from the scaffold. In this we are having items, and in this item I'm gonna pass my list, and in this pair of parentheses I'm gonna design my list item column. So in this column we are having modifier, fill max, width. Into this we are having a row, and again this row have modifier, fill max, width, and its horizontal arrangement would be space between. And also I want some padding, so for that in this modifier I'm gonna add padding horizontally 12 dp and vertically 8 dp. Import this thing. Next we are having here vertical alignment, which is again on the center vertically. And in this row we are having two things. So the first is our text, which is coming from to-do title. So use here checkbox, and this checkbox initial value is coming from the it dot is done. So for that I'm using here a state, and the state name is check, initialized with the help of remember mutable state of it dot is done. And I'm gonna use this is check in my checkbox. So is check value, and if anything got changed, I'm gonna use here is checked value and update it. I want to also update my database based on this checkbox change. So how can we do it? Well, it's very easy. I'm gonna use my intent. In this intent we are having to do intent that contain update. First let me rename this thing from check, and now I'm gonna replace this it with check. In this update I'm gonna take my to do, make a copy of it, and in place of is done I'm gonna pass my check. So this will eventually update my local database. Lastly I'm gonna use here horizontal divider in this column. So this is my list item. Now I want to wrap this if and else block in a column. In this column we are having modifier, fill max size, but before that we have to take the padding which is coming from the scaffold, and remove this box padding and our lazy column modifier, because we had already taken inner padding in my main column. In this box I'm gonna use here weight 1f. Similarly for the lazy column I'm gonna use weight 1f. Just below to this if else here we are having column, and this column having modifier, fill max, width, and also the horizontal arrangement is on the center. So first thing is our text field. And next we are having button, and this button has a UI save to do. So for the text field we have to create a state. So on the top I'm gonna create a state, and the state name is title remember mutable state of empty string. Now go below, here we are having a text field. Simply use your title value, and if anything got changed you can update your title value. And also I'm gonna use here modifier, fill max, width. That's it for our text field. And for the button click I'm gonna use here on intent. With the help of my to do intent dot insert I'm gonna insert a new item. So the requirement of insert is to do. So let's create a to do. In place of title I'm gonna use my title value. In place of is done I'm gonna send false, and id is of course 0. And once we insert the item to my database I'm gonna reset my title value to empty string. So we are done with our update and insertion. Now it's time to see how we can delete a to-do item. So for delete, go to your lazy column list item. We are having here column, and in this I'm gonna attach combine clickable. In this combine clickable we are having enable. So yes, I want to enable this. We are having our on click, and also we are having on long click. This is an experimental API, so you have to add experimental foundation API on top of our composable. Now when user long click to my to do item I'm going to delete it. So on intent invoke do intent dot delete, and simply pass your to do. So now our application main screen is done. So go to the top. In this scaffold I'm going to create a surface, and in this surface I'm having a modifier, and this modifier has padding. Simply pass the inner padding, and in this I'm going to pass my main screen. So the requirement of main screen is list. In order to get list what we have to do, we will use our repository. So wall list, this is initialized with the help of our repository get all to do list, and I want to collect this in a form of state, and initial value is empty list. Import this thing, and now we will have our list. Simply pass your list. In this lambda we are receiving intent when our intent. So in this we are having three different subclasses. So use all of your branches, delete, insert, and update. So on delete what we need to do, we have to create a scope first. So wall scope remember coroutine scope, because repository other functions like insert, update, delete is a suspendable function. So in order to execute suspendable function, we will have to create a coroutine. Scope.launch, and I want to launch this thing to my dispatcher.io. So for the delete, I'm gonna use a repository, delete it. In delete, we have to pass our to-do that we want to delete, which is coming from intent. Similarly, for the insert, I'm gonna use scope.launch, and in this, I'm gonna use a repository, insert, pass my to-do, intent.todo. For the update, I'm gonna use again the same thing, scope.launch. Repository update, pass your intent to do, and also make sure to use dispatcher io because this is a database operation. Alright, so we are pretty much done with our project. So what we did in this project, we saw how to use MVI architecture in our to do application. So MVI architecture contains three different things: model, view, intent. So responsibility of model is to get data either from local or remote data source. Apart from this, it also contains all of your business logic. Intent contain all of our intents that we want to perform into our application. Next, we are having view. So view contains our composable screen or XMLs. So now it's time to execute this application. All right, so our app is executing. Now I want to insert something. So first to do, save to do. And here you can see this is my first to do. Now simply check on it and close the application. Remove this application from recent and open this application one more time and see it persist. Now if you want to delete it, you can simply hold on to it and it will delete. So this is a very simple to-do app that we have designed with MVI architecture. If you are having any doubts, you can simply write a comment for that. This is all for our video. We will meet on next video where we will discuss something new about Android development. Till that, goodbye.